Woman is part of a research team working on a cure for the coronavirus. KTAB's Jessica Rank spoke with her about a treatment that has been nearly 6 years in the making.
As another week of silence sets in, people in the key city are looking for a way to get back to some sort of normalcy. And while social distancing measures are still in place, some are looking for a more permanent solution to the virus.
I'm a dentist, but I'm also the senior research scientist for a photomedicine company.
And on top of all of that, Lacey Mankin is representing the key city in a major research project.
She became part of a team that had approached me with the idea of building a device that would help treat diseases with light.
And while the project started 6 years ago with the possible treatment of Ebola, the team says it could factor into what we're facing now.
And we believe that this has a lot of potential for doing things like lowering the amount of virus in the body.
And Lacey explains the reaction similar to how a piece of hair reacts to a flame, taking away the strength of a virus, similar to how this piece of hair is weakening.
It works for hepatitis viruses, herpes viruses, all sorts of things that have been studied.
So what would the treatment look like? Dr. Bob, who was a former VP of Johns Hopkins, describes it much like donating blood or platelets.
Basically, you put an IV in the patient, drain out approximately 3 cc's per kilogram of body weight, run it through a device over ultraviolet light, and then send it back into the body.
But the work isn't quite over yet. And whether it works or not, Lacey says it's a bit of hope for the future.
I just really wanted to see it work and see other people be able to use it because it gives you relief, even if you're not struggling with the coronavirus.
Thank you, Jessica, for that report. The team has tested the UV treatment on other viruses, and those have worked successfully. The group is now applying for grants to test the coronavirus.